An assertion is a true-false statement, a Boolean expression, about the values of the variables in a program. In this sequence, an assertion has been placed in a comment on the second line. The assertion is true at that point. In this sequence, the assertion is also true. In this sequence, the assertion is false. We shouldn't write such things. Because we put assertions within a program at various places to help the reader understand the program. When we place an assertion in a program, we are asserting that the assertion is true at that point, hence the name assertion. The assertions in the examples are written in mathematics. When placed in assert statements in Java, they have to be written in Java. But often, when we write them as comments in a program, they may be written in math, English, or a combination of both. The important point is not the language, but the clarity and precision with which they are written. Here are some assertions we might place in programs. Later on, we will show how we can use pictures of arrays as assertions. The precondition of a statement is the assertion that precedes it. The postcondition of a statement is the assertion that follows it. In this sequence, statement X becomes 5 has no precondition, but it has postcondition X equals 5. The next statement, X becomes X plus 2, has precondition X equals 5, but it has no postcondition. In 1969, Sir Tony Hoare introduced the following notation, now called a Hoare Triple, where P, the precondition, and Q, the postcondition, are assertions, and S is a statement, or is a sequence of statements. I said Sir Tony Hoare because Tony was knighted by the Queen of England for his many contributions to computer science, and especially to his work on correctness of programs. This notation is itself a true-false statement with this meaning. If S is executed in a state in which P is true, then S is guaranteed to terminate, and when it does, Q will be true. For example, you can see that this Hoare triple is true. Some people put braces around assertions in a comment in order to distinguish assertions from other kinds of comments. We will not follow that practice, writing the Hoare triple instead, as shown here. If precondition P is false, then the Hoare triple guarantees nothing about execution, and execution of S can do anything. It can get into an infinite loop, it can stop immediately with no guarantees about what state it is in, it can abort, perhaps by dividing by zero. That's because of its meaning. Its meaning is, if S is executed in a state in which P is true, then dot, dot, dot. That sentence says nothing about what will happen if P is not true. In Java, we put preconditions in method specifications. For example, in this specification, array B should not contain zero values because the average of zero values is undefined. The precondition in the specification is actually the precondition in this Hoare triple. It is true when the method body starts execution. As we have stated earlier in this course, if a method is called with the precondition false, the method can do whatever it wants. That goes right along with the notation of the Hoare triple. However, in many cases, we can help debug Java programs more easily by placing assert statements at the beginning of methods to catch false preconditions. In this case, we can put at the beginning of S the statement assert b.length not equal to zero. In summary, If the precondition is false, we can do anything we want in the method body. But often we decide to do something that helps us catch errors more quickly.